We electrofished Crane Creek and removed some brook trout that were in an interface zone with brown trout. And we were able to take those fish in oxygenated containers and relocate those to another stream so that they weren't impacted during this restoration project. We use electrofishing to temporarily stun fish so we can collect those in nets, backpacks that have battery packs with DC or alternating current are placed on our backs, and we have probe systems that go in the water and actually stuns the fish temporarily so we can net the fish and collect fish. And we also used electrofishing to monitor the population so that we know what was in the stream before we removed the fish. We collected the fish out of Crane Creek, and we took those fish in buckets to a tank in a truck, hauled those fish to the Tomasi Creek area. Trout have very stringent water quality requirements, so they require a lot of dissolved oxygen, so it is necessary that we oxygenate and aerate during transportation. We place those fish in oxygenated bags and put those oxygenated bags in backpacks and hike the fish into Tomasi Creek. Release site for relocated trout, we look for good water quality. That's temperature, pH, those water hardness, those type factors. We're also looking for good habitat, which includes good pool and riffle habitat, good substrate for spawning habitat for the fish. These are wild brook trout, and we have learned from other studies over the years that wild fish tend to be better than hatchery domesticated fish to repopulate a stream. And these brook trout should spawn next month. So that was another reason we wanted to put these fish in just right before their spawning time, so they could, before they had any angling pressure, they could be spawning in the creek.
It was a perfect opportunity to get out here and work with the DNR and Dan Rankin and just spend some time trying to deliver these trout that are replenishing some streams that have no fish in them. And so I've really enjoyed it, and everybody's been great to work with.
We have to locate a barrier where brown and rainbow trout, non-native trout, cannot move back into the area that we're restoring for the eastern brook trout. So we start from that point, that waterfall barrier, and move upstream, and we have stations about every 100 meters. And this restoration project will restore eastern brook trout to about 4 miles of stream. The upper end is about 2,400 feet elevation, down to about 1,800 feet at the waterfall on the lower end. This is basically a reservoir bucket that we put water and the Antimycin in. Mm-hmm. It's 8 parts per billion, so it's very low concentration. But this is a reservoir, and it just maintains head pressure and flows down into a treater, and it will maintain a steady stream that flows out into the stream. But it's very much not toxic to non-target aquatic organisms like aquatic insects. Mm-hmm. It's not toxic to crayfish. Crayfish have a copper-based blood system, and this doesn't affect aquatic animals with a copper-based blood system. So it doesn't affect a lot of the other aquatics that we're concerned about, but it does selectively take out fish out of the stream. We track the flow or the progress of the Antimycin in the stream using dye. It's a fluorescein dye that we use. It's a harmless chemical, but it's very visible, and it helps us track. So when the dye gets there, we know that that's simultaneous with the Antimycin reaching that site. So that's when we know to turn on the detoxification. The detox site is necessary that we run to be sure that we aren't impacting fish downstream of the restoration area. Fish and other aquatic organisms also could be impacted if we did not detoxify the Antimycin. We use potassium permanganate, which is an oxidizer, and this is a very effective way of making certain that we have detoxified below the restoration site.
Okay, Dan, so we're downstream of a treatment station.
Right.
And tell me what this box is about.
This box is a live cage, and these fish are fish. We have to sacrifice a few fish to be able to tell that this treatment is working and that we are removing all of the fish that we want to out of the stream. But these fish in this cage are basically the canary in the coal mine. We put these below a treatment station to let us know that the treatment is effective and that we are taking out the non-native fish.
Mm-hmm. So this is one of five streams that we're trying to restore brook trout in, and this is on Forest Service land. And Dan plans to continue doing more work on other state waters other than the Forest Service after we have finished this part of the project. We are also looking at other streams on Forest Service land to restore in the future.
Mm-hmm. And so in unique areas where we can work above waterfalls and get streams brought back, you know, and remove non-natives or hybrid brook trout, if that may be the case, then it's a golden opportunity for us to do that. And it's great to be able to work with folks like Dan and these guys and do a partnership between agencies that really does bring that back.
Trout fishing in the state is a very important resource. Brings in over $17 million annually. It's a very important recreational resource. And our brown and rainbow trout fisheries are very important to us. But we have selected a few streams just so that we can preserve our native eastern brook trout populations as well.
So we're in King Creek now. And tell me what we're looking for that'll show us the success of the restoration here.
Gene, we restocked brook trout in here last fall before spawning season, so we're hopeful to see some of the adult fish that we originally restocked, also some young of the year fish that may, some reproduction from those adult fish from last fall.
And y'all have been in here since then? Shocking.
Right, we have one time back in the summer and had really good success. We saw young of the year fish and the adult fish, which was a good sign. Got him.
And there's one.
And there's one. He's about a year old now because brook trout, we're early October and brook trout spawn in late October, early November.
Uh-huh. How do you want things to go in your restoration streams over the next few years?
Well, Gene, hopefully in the next 3 to 4 years we'll see more young of the year in the stream and more adult fish that will benefit fishing and angling, especially further downstream as this stream gets larger.